Hello everyone, this is a quick start video of our new codec, TAC5242 evaluation module, and we are going to walk you through how to use this EVM. This video could also be used as a reference of our new converter family, ADC TAA5242 and DAC TAD5242 EVM setup. We'll cover the basic setup of this TAC5242 evaluation module and the demo of ADC and DAC performance. TAC5242, TAA5242, and TAD5242 are hardware control devices. There is no software needed to program these devices. The EVM package consists of the EVM daughterboard, housing the audio converters, and the ACMB motherboard. The ACMB provides a power to the EVM and provides an option to send or receive audio between the PC and the EVM. To power up the EVM, you'll need a micro USB cable to connect the ACMB to your PC. The EVM kit also contains extra jumpers for more complex configurations. In this video, audio data will be analyzed through Audio Procession APX555. We'll get started with ACMB configurations. First of all, connect the ACMB to the EVM using the screw post. Since we are using the Audio Procession as our audio host, S0 will need to be set to off to disconnect the EVM from the USB audio interface. Short J5 for 5-volt USB power supply. You'll notice that LED on D3 turning on when the ACMB is powered up. After setting up the ACMB, the EVM will also need to be configured according to the user settings. The image shows an overview of different audio functions on the EVM. Let's explore the configuration that EVM allows. This video will cover two common input settings: differential onboard microphone, and differential line input. Please refer to the user guide for other configurations. For the AC couple, differentials, onboard ECM microphone setting, please install J4, J5, J8, J11, J12, 1 and 2, and left J6, J15, J16, J20, J21 open. The jumper mark in red will need to be shorted. By playing a 1K sine wave close to the ECM microphone, we can see that microphone is recording the sine wave. This proves that our ADC path is working. For AC coupled differential line input, jumper JA will be the only jumper that will need to be shorted. Please leave rest of them open. The screen shows the setting of measuring ADC dynamic range with differential line input. Channel 1 is now showing 118.5 dB dynamic range. EVM analog audio output port provides options for AC or DC coupled, and filter or filter last path for easy evaluations. The filter components are not populated by default. Differential output will require J36 and J37 to be left open. Switch SW1 allows user to select a load for each output paired. The load options are 16 ohms, 604 ohms, 10K ohms, and open if needed. Please see the user guide for more output architecture information. TAC5242 is a hardware control device and requires device configuration to be set through the multifunction device pin from MD0 to MD5. In this demo, we'll be using target TDM audio format for the APX555. J70 will be set to ground with 4.7K ohms. MD1 to MD5, which are jumper J71 to J75, will be shorted to ground as we're using 32-bit stereo differential AC couple mode for record, and 32-bit stereo differential AC couple line out for playback. The user guide will cover more detailed multifunction pin settings. One soft reminder is that the jumper below MD3 test point is actually AVDD, and the MD3 setting will be set by jumper J73, which is the one on the left side of MD3 test point. The screen now shows the setting to measure the DAC dynamic range with the APX555. Channel 1 is now showing 120 dB dynamic range. This TAC5242 EVM Quick Start video could also be applied to similar devices like TAD5242, TAD5142, TAA5242, and TAC5142 EVM. For more information, please visit ti.com/tool/part-number-and-evm-k for detailed user guide and E2E forums for any question you may have. Thank you.